dating rock art is actually a very, very difficult thing to do because the paintings themselves can't be dated by any techniques we have at our disposal today. So the rock art dating project has had to spend quite a lot of time understanding what happens on the rock surfaces that are painted in order to find things that have happened during time that we can date. That means we have to understand the very nature of the rock shelters themselves, but we've been able to establish that they don't fall down for a very long time. Many of the rock shelters can survive for periods of up to 40,000 years, and in some cases probably well over 100,000 years. But also then we had to look within the gallery at the actual rock faces that are painted to find out if there is anything happening on those rock surfaces gradually over time that gives us points of reference which we can date and can relate to the rock art. One of the most interesting of these has been using the mud wasp nests. Mud wasps are big wasps that go and collect little balls of mud, and they come and they daub this on the rock surfaces. Most of the nests actually crumble away relatively quickly, probably in a few tens of years, but there's a small remnant, a little elliptical ring around each cell of the nest that survives. It sticks very tenaciously to the rock surface. And there's very little material in it, but if we are able to date that, then we know that any painting that has been painted over that nest subsequently must be younger than that nest. And then if there are new nests on top of the paintings, then the painting must be older than that. And it has given us a tremendous amount of insight into the ages of the different styles of paintings that are found in the Kimberley repertoire of rock art. The oldest paintings, commonly known as the irregular infill animal period, are paintings done in various ochres and are very, very tenacious. They stay there through thick and thin for long periods of time. By dating lots and lots and lots of these mud wasp nests, Damien Finch, one of our research scientists, has been able to, first of all, demonstrate that there are tiny little particles of charcoal, and there is enough carbon that can now be dated by radiocarbon dating. And from that we have lots and lots of ages that are either maximum ages or minimum ages of the various paintings. And we've been able to show that that earliest irregular infill period has dates going back now in excess of 18,000 years ago. That is the outstanding example, and it is, in fact, at the moment, the oldest painting that is still in place on a rock wall that has a published age for it. And then there is a later period, the Guion style, where the emphasis of the painting changes completely from animals to people, and people in ceremonial dress. Very different cultural emphasis in what is being painted. Those paintings, Damien has also got a lot of mud wasp nest dates for, and there seems to be a major culmination of that period at around 12,500 years ago. And of course there are other periods that are younger than that that we are currently gathering a lot of data for using this particular method. The importance of that is that the dates for those two periods, they're the two oldest painted styles, is that the world changed dramatically in that period. If we go back to 20,000 years ago, that is when the whole globe was in the grips of the last great ice age. And that lasted from about 24,000 years down to about 18,000 years. So we're seeing paintings that have survived since that particular period. Then by about 18,000 years ago, in the great ice caps in the northern hemisphere, on North America and Scandinavia and Britain and Siberia, they began to melt. And as they melted, all of that water, which was locked up on land, made its way into the oceans, and sea levels globally rose by about 125 metres. So we now know that those paintings actually belong to the very beginning of that, in the deep ice age conditions, a very different climate to what we have today. The land was much more extensive, sea levels were much lower, and the shoreline was hundreds of kilometres offshore from where it is today in the Kimberley. So the dating of that has all sorts of very important consequences. The mud wasp nests are just one of four different techniques that we're using to date the rock art. Another method that is intimately related to the gradual evolution of the rock shelters themselves and their eventual collapse. We can date the various rock falls that are involved in that life cycle of a rock shelter by using the exposure of blocks of sandstone to cosmic rays from space. Because when these rocks are on the ceiling of a rock shelter, they are sheltered from cosmic radiation by the overlying rocks. But after they fall, they usually fall down and out of the rock shelters and they become exposed to maybe a third or half of the sky, and they get impacted by cosmic rays, and that creates tiny, tiny quantities of radioactive elements which we can measure. And that sets a maximum limit for any new paintings which are painted on the new back walls of the shelters or on the new ceilings that are formed as a result of that rock fall. We have about 40 of those big slab falls dated now by this cosmogenic radionuclide dating method. We're also able to date very large mud wasp nests, and we can date those by a different method called the optically stimulated luminescence dating method, or OSL to its friends. There's also another method of dating, a mineral deposit which accumulates on the floors of the rock shelters and on low angled surfaces. And we've discovered that these are finely laminated in particular patterns. And we've made the remarkable discovery that in fact the patterns of the laminations in these mineral deposits are the same in different rock shelters that are spread over an area of some 2,000 square kilometres. That is an extraordinary find, because it means that something outside the individual rock shelters is actually influencing the deposition of these layers. We have dates now going back from about 1,000 years ago back to over 40,000 years. And they have been the medium in which a lot of engravings have been carved. And in many cases, you can see that new layers have grown over the top of these. So by dating the layers that have been cut through, we can also now embark on a program of dating these engravings, which have been thought to be the very oldest evidence of rock art in the Kimberley. So in all of these dating methods, we are building up a lot of results. We hope by the end of 2023 to have more than 500 dates. One of the most important things about this project and doing it on the scale that we've been able to do, we've had the funding from Rock Art Australia, we've had the funding from the Australian Research Council, which means that we're able to do this properly. And it needs to be done at scale because it doesn't make sense to have the odd date here or there. So we're able to do this in a way that has actually never been done before. I don't know of anywhere else in the world which has such a clearly defined sequence of different rock art styles that start from today, going right back for tens of thousands of years. And the styles change through that time. And we now have our first tentative timescale. We know roughly where the boundaries between these different styles occurred. So that means we can relate them to the things that are happening in terms of how climate was varying. The traditional owners that we work with today are intimately involved in the research. We have been working with the same group of people from Kalumburu in the North Kimberley since the very beginning of the project, all under the auspices of the senior traditional owner who speaks for that country, Augie Unhango, who has been a wonderful guide and mentor for all of us. We have built a relationship with the young Aboriginal people in the area, and they have worked with us very closely. They know what we are doing. We understand what's important to them. So it's been a wonderful privilege for us as the scientists involved to be able to join our knowledge system with theirs and build up the picture, the complete picture, as it were, of this wonderful heritage in Australia.